Yeah, I'm still a little bit sick. So I'm not one to lie to you guys. I'm filming this video 2 days in the future. Yeah, I know. It's the vlog for the 8th, but I'm filming it on the 10th. Because I've had a couple of days of just feeling like crap. Still. Like, I'm still ill. I took off on the 8th from work, and I stayed home. But that doesn't mean that we don't have stuff to talk about in today's vlog. Because we got a Nintendo Direct. And I didn't take off work to see the Nintendo Direct. I took off work because I was ill, but it was a nice bonus to being off work. So I'm not going to touch on every single thing that we saw in this Direct, but I am going to touch on the stuff that really, like, was good for me, the stuff that I really enjoyed seeing. And that starts off right at the beginning. We got Pikmin 4. Just right off the bat. We already knew Pikmin 4 existed. We knew it was a thing that was coming. I did not expect to be getting news on it quite yet. But we did. We got quite a bit of Pikmin 4 gameplay. It looks gorgeous. Let's just open with that. It looks absolutely gorgeous. We got to see the new captains, what they look like. We got to see a new type of Pikmin, being the Ice Pikmin, which can freeze enemies kind of like the Ultra Bitter Spray. And then when you defeat them while they're frozen, they just get completely destroyed and you get a little bit of nectar from them. So that's violent as hell. And the Ice Pikmin can also freeze bodies of water, it looks like, but you have to leave them in the water for the body of water to stay frozen. So that's interesting. We also got the reveal of Ochi or Oachi. I don't know the official pronunciation of it, but a little dog. We're going to call him Pick Dog, or just Pikmin Dog. That's what we've been referring to him as. But yeah, he looks like a great addition to the gameplay, I gotta say. You can ride on his back, he can swim across bodies of water, he can bring things back to your base. I think he has the same power as a purple Pikmin. He has like the power of 10. It looks incredible. And then right at the end of the Pikmin 4 trailer, we got a little bit of a tease of potentially a nighttime mode, which is kind of incredible because we've never had anything like that, you know, where you can come back at night. The whole thing about Pikmin is like, okay, yeah, everything gets really aggressive at night, go up into the sky so that you don't die. But apparently in this one, or it seems to be, that you might be able to come back at nighttime. So that's exciting. We got, well, there was some Xenoblade DLC that I just don't care about. And then Samba de Amigo is a thing that happened. I don't think we've had a Samba de Amigo game since the Wii, and the only time I've really seen him has been in like Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing and Sonic and All-Stars Racing Transformed. So neat. I'll probably pick that up. It seems like a fun little rhythm party game. And also it's just nice to see Sega like acknowledging their other IPs other than Sonic, because you know, we haven't seen Samba de Amigo in so long. It gives me hope for Billy Hatcher. Next big thing that I was interested in was actually Bayonetta Origins, Cereza, and the Lost Demon. I haven't really played much of the other Bayonetta games, but I do have this one pre-ordered because it's not like your typical Bayonetta game. It looks completely different. I love the art style, and just getting to play like Bayonetta's origin story, I think is just cool. And I'm pretty excited about it, I gotta say. Splatoon 3 Expansion Pass DLC. They announced a couple of waves, the first one being quite literally just you take a train and you go to Inkopolis from the first game. And I don't think it's anything more than just a cosmetic hub. At least that's what it seems to be. Because they didn't really show anything else. They're just like, hey, you can go to the hub world from the first game if you want, and you can go to all the shops, you can do everything that you can do in the regular place, including Salmon Run, I think. I think they said that Grizzco has, like, set up shop here. So that's kind of neat. And Callie and Marie are going to be performing during Splatfest, so it's neat. I gotta blow my nose so bad, oh my god. So as I was walking back over here, my knee gave out. and then my shoulder just cracked. I'm having a time. And then the second part of the Splatoon 3 DLC, not too much was said about it, but it's called Side Order. And it looks like you're in the hub of Splatoon 2. I think that's where that is. I could be completely wrong, but I want to say that's the hub world for Splatoon 2. And everything's covered in white, and it looks like you're playing as a young Marina. I could be wrong on that, but it looks like a young Marina. And yeah, people are saying, oh, this is a what-if scenario on if Order won the final Splatfest of Splatoon 2, which is interesting. Don't know for sure. Don't know why Order would mean that everything is just white, but I guess we'll have to wait and see. We love Katamari Reroll. I didn't expect that. I don't think anybody was really anticipating another Katamari remake, but hey, I played Katamari Damacy Reroll and I loved it, and because I played the Katamari games when I was younger. And now we're getting another one, and you get to play as the King of All Cosmos. So, no complaints from me. I'll gladly take more Katamari. Advance Wars 1 plus 2 Reboot Camp finally got another release date. I believe they said like April sometime. I'm just glad to see that game is in fact still coming. Of course, it was delayed because of all the war going on over in Ukraine. Which is totally understandable and respectable. I'm just glad that it is finally coming out, because I played a lot of Advance Wars Dual Strike on my DS. And I'm excited to give this one a go and play the original games in a new form. And that's just the first half of the Direct. We're getting into some meaty stuff right now. Kirby's Return to Dream Land Deluxe got a confirmed epilogue with Magalore, where you actually play as Magalore, which is pretty cool. This was leaked a little bit beforehand. It was the back of the box was leaked, but hey, it's nice that in this remake of a Wii game, they're adding more content. Super, super nice. And then a big drop, Game Boy, Game Boy Color, and Game Boy Advance are all coming to Nintendo Switch Online. I say are all coming, they're all here. They came out immediately. They're going to be adding a lot more games to them, of course, but the notable ones for me, especially from GBA, they added Mario Kart Super Circuit, so you can do Super Circuit 4-player online. Mario & Luigi Superstar Saga, which is a great game, one of my childhood favorites from the GBA. Kirby Tilt and Tumble from the Game Boy. Maybe that was Game Boy Color, I forget. That was a game that had, like, gyro control built into the cartridge. So it's really interesting that they're doing that one. And that's one that I've been like, okay, I want to let's play that, but I have no idea how to do it. Now I know how to do it. It also makes me think maybe they're going to add Yoshi Topsy Turvy to the GBA library. And then we also got confirmation that Kirby and the Amazing Mirror is coming to the GBA one, which is another four-player multiplayer GBA game that would be impossible to record for a Let's Play, but not anymore. And that's just the tip of the iceberg. I'm sure they're going to keep adding more and more games, and I'm super happy that the Game Boys are here on the Switch. Oh, and then they just were like, hey, we've remade or remastered the original Metroid Prime, and it's out now. So that was kind of a ginormous bombshell, but yeah, cool. It's getting a physical release in a few weeks, but the digital version is available right now. Incredible. I hope they do Prime 2 and 3. We got a really short confirmation of a brand new Professor Layton game coming out. We haven't seen Layton in so long, but that's exciting. I haven't played any of his games, but it's exciting to see a new one coming. And then one of the last big things that I cared about was, of course, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, the Booster Course Pass Wave 4. We got confirmation of a Yoshi's Island track, a brand new course coming based on Yoshi's Island, which looks absolutely gorgeous. Like, compared to the other new courses we've had added, like, Ninja Hideaway and the Sweet one, I'm completely forgetting the name of, that were added to tour after the fact, this one looks the nicest. And then Birdo! We're getting characters in the Booster Course Pass. Bring on Funky Kong. Then we had a couple more things, and then, of course, Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. We got another teaser trailer. We still don't know a whole lot about this game, but it seems like we heard Ganondorf talking. I think it was Ganondorf. We don't know. We don't know what the hell's going on with this game at the moment, but I'm picking it up. It comes out in May. I'm assuming we're going to get some kind of dedicated direct for this game before it comes out. And I'm just super looking forward to it. I haven't played through Breath of the Wild in so long. And getting more of that type of game is really exciting. And I'm super looking forward to this one. And that's pretty much it. I did a reaction video to this direct with Billy. So you can catch my initial reactions by clicking the link right up here. Is it up here? I think it's up here. I don't remember. I want to say it appears right up there. It's in one of the corners and in the description. So you can go catch our initial reactions to everything. And I just kind of wanted to discuss it here on the vlog. I'm thrilled. That this was one of the best directs we've had in forever. And I think it's going to take a lot for Nintendo to top this one. Oh, also Amiibo. We're getting a Link Amiibo for Tears of the Kingdom. You better bet I already pre-ordered it. That's going to be it for today, though. So thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for tomorrow, and I'll see you guys then.